Welcome to Psychic Medium Toni Green. Here we are doing another show on another Monday. I am going to be taking callers this morning. The call-in number is 845-277-9131. Now, if you are watching on YouTube, you can say hello in the live chat. You can also call in. And if you're watching on any of the stations or podcasts that air the show, every Monday and Wednesday at noon Central, I go live and you can join in. You can call in or you can join in on YouTube Live. Why was that such a difficult sentence to get out? Okay, so before I go to callers, I want to tell you a few songs because they've been coming through all weekend. And some of these songs, I normally would not think of these songs. They're not songs that I would think of. So if I mention a song or sing lyrics that are familiar to you or represent somebody on the other side, this song is probably for you. So the first song is Slow Ride. Slow Ride. Take it easy. Is that it? Or is it Take It Sleazy? Can somebody tell me, is it Take It Easy or Take It Sleazy? I just feel like somebody wouldn't say Take It Sleazy in a song. I feel it's Take It Easy. I'm just going to go with it. Take It Easy. Slow Ride, Take It Easy. And that's the only verse I am getting. So I want to say, if that song meant something to you or somebody on the other side, that message is for you from them. And that's a confirmation from you for them. No, for you from them. The other song is a song I'm really not familiar with that much, and as a matter of fact, now the words are going, well, they're throwing another song in first, and it's that little ditty about Jack and Diane, two American kids growing up in the heartland, that song. So if that meant something to you or somebody on the other side, or you and somebody on the other side, that is there. And then there's somebody named Glenn, either listening or on the other side, somebody named Glenn, but I feel like this person is, are you on the other side? Yep. Somebody named Glenn on the other side is saying, I love you, I love you, I love you. And I'm gonna halt it there. If that other song comes in that I was thinking of all weekend, I will 1,000,000% say it and let you know what it was. Okay, so we are gonna go. We're gonna get started now. And there's I keep hearing Emily, 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 Emily. And I've been hearing that name all weekend also. So if that means something to you, please know if it's a confirmation one way or the other, okay? I want to thank everybody watching on YouTube, chatting with me. Thank you for saying hello. Hello, everybody who just checked in. Fawn, hey, Fawn. Cheryl, Fawn, Mimi, Mimi, thank you for doing all the timestamps. And then, Heather, who is the random person. Okay, we are going to start with a clearing, and we are going to start with a clearing. Heather has asked for a clearing on being able to make clear decisions. And I think that comes from not second guessing ourselves. So we second guess ourselves. So we don't make the choice, right? So we are second guessing ourselves. I get a yes. So let's start clearing that. And then as we go through the show today, we're going to do more clearings. These clearings are healings you can listen to, re-listen to every day, every week, whatever works out for you, okay? You can come back to any of my shows. There are a significant amount of healings or clearings in each and every show. And yes. Hey, Stevie. So, okay, you guys, I just have to share this is like the craziest story to me. So my youngest brother, who has Downs, as we all know, he cracks me up so much. So he's 40 years old and he has a phone, of course. So he totally has been able to find some of my shows on YouTube. I don't even know how, but he does. He calls me up. He's like, Toni. And then he tells me like all these things. So he actually found one of my shows that I did with Laurent. Hey, Laurent, how are you? Laurent is this tattoo artist in Bayview, Wisconsin, who is amazing. But this show has to be, this show is pre-pandemic, pre-shutdown. And it was done at the WSCS studio, Create a Life You Love. And my youngest brother does have a tattoo on his arm. My mom took him in for it. And so he calls me and he says, I saw the show, and will you take me to Laurent for another tattoo? And I'm like, oh, I will take you to see Laurent, but you have to get your dad to okay that, and then we can go with that. So that was like the funniest thing to me. And we think Siri and Alexa and all of them are not listening. I'm telling you something. I have to totally shut things off when I do my show, because otherwise they're responding, whether you say their name or not. So there's that. All righty, folks, here we go. The first caller I'm going to go to. I'm really excited. And thank you, guys. Thank you, everybody, so much for calling in, listening in, watching in, rewatching, whatever it is that you're doing. I love you guys so, so much. Thank you for being here and taking time out of your day to join me on this show. I'm going to go to 305. Hey, what's your name? Where are you calling from? Hello?
I'm in South Florida. I'm in South Florida. My name is Deanna.
Deanna. Okay,
and Deanna. I've got a huge problem, but I was wondering if you, with the help of spirit, can guide me.
I'll do the best I can. What's your question, love?
Well, where to go? I'm going to be taken out from where I've been living this week, maybe today. And where am I going to go?
Okay, so the first thing I hear is it's a friend or a family. That's going to be your first step. I don't feel like you are going to be... you know what, sweetie? Okay, so here's what I'm going to tell you, and I hope this is helpful. And I know this is not always the step we want to take, but I'm going to say everything I'm hearing. So please listen to all the words, not just some of them. And sweetie, your phone is making some noise. So I'm just going to mute you while I give you my answer, and then I'll come back to you. Okay. So the first thing I'm hearing is you're either going to end up with a friend or a family or in a shelter. Now, this isn't like a homeless shelter. I feel like this is more of a woman's shelter. I feel like this is someplace for your own safety, someplace that is going to allow you to be, I'm hearing the word, be invisible for a while, be invisible for a period of time while you get get things together. Now, I don't care. Listen, I don't care what kind of shelter it is. I don't care if it's a homeless shelter. I don't care if it's a woman's shelter. If it's what you need, it's what you need. I would reach out to a church or two to get into that, to see if I feel like there's going to be a church that could help you. Maybe not today or tomorrow, to find some place to live today or tomorrow. But I do feel like if you go to a church, they may be able to help you with a reference to somebody who has a place to stay. I am going to tell you, but you do need to move quickly. Don't, I'm hearing like it's like they're saying it in a cartoon voice, and I know that your situation isn't funny, but they're saying, you gotta go, don't be slow, get it? Like they're smacking their hand. They're like, stop effing around. You need to get it together. So I feel like that if you do, you know, this is one of those, this is one of those by choice or by force. If you don't move, they are going to move you. Boom, 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 boom. And I'm sorry to say that, and I'm sorry to say it like that, but for your own safety and so that you can start to take control of your life again, you need to really make these moves. Now, I'm going to say this one more time, just in case. So please listen and re-listen to the show if you need to, beautiful girl. The first thing they want to say is there may be a friend and or family. Now, all these first things they're saying are temporary situations to help you get to the next step, okay? This is not a permanent solution. I'm not saying call up a friend and be like, hey, can I couch surf and plan on staying there forever? That is not it. Independence is crucial. But I do feel like there is either a friend or family member you might be able to stay with as long as you have a plan and you present that plan to them. The next thing is possibly some sort of woman's shelter. And the last thing is to reach out to a church. Now, when you're last minute, like kind of on the fly, trying to find a place to live or stay, I think it's very important that you look at every single option and you don't work one until you find out if that one works out. It's like looking for a job when your rent is due. You're calling every place, including, and don't be offended, folks. Don't come at me for this, including the strip clubs. Hey, you need a bouncer? Hey, you need a waitress? You are going wherever you need to go to get where you need to be, okay? There's no time for, well, I'm going to wait to see what my friend says. That was a month ago. That was a month ago. Now you in a place where I'm going to call 5 or 10 different places, 6 different churches, 5 different women's shelters, and volunteer places to see who can help me. And I'm going to do them all at the same time, because if in case one can't, somebody else is going to. And if they can't help me, I'm not going to hang up. I'm going to say, can you please lead me? Can you please give me the name and number of somebody who can? Okay, that's where you need to be, baby girl. And that is what is going to be your strongest thing. In this moment, there are a couple of different places that might have opportunities for you, but you have to start now. You have got to start now, and you cannot be in denial about this. And I'm going to do a clearing for you and for anybody else who is stuck, because I feel like you are stuck. You're in a very emotionally traumatized state right now. Things did not go the way you thought they were going to go. And you are looking for, it doesn't matter what you're looking for. You're just stuck. So we are stuck. I get a yes. We are going to start clearing that. Now, it doesn't matter if you're stuck finding a place to live, finding a job, getting more money. in a relationship. Holy moly, baby girl, that is a big one. And I also, because I feel like there is trauma involved in this, and there is. Yeah, because I'm, oh yeah, there is. Hoo-wee-choo-chee. How, wah-wah. Okay, we have, all trauma has been cleared. I get a no. Let's start clearing that. Now, this is for you, anybody listening, anybody re-listening, and that was at about the 15-minute mark. I'm going to say something here. We think because we made it or survived through something, we don't have trauma anymore. It's not really true. It's not. We can make it through a lot of things and then still carry that trauma and hold it someplace in our body. So for anybody listening, re-listening, anybody who has gone through any trauma, whether you're watching on WSCS, Roku TV, Rude Rangers TV. Hey, Rudy. Hey, Amber. Hey, Rude Rangers TV. I love you guys so much. Hey, Scott from WSCS. No matter where you're watching this or listening to this, I'm going to tell you, just listen to that trauma part again and again. I mean, being birthed is traumatic. If you ask all the specialists, think about that process. I mean, come on, being birthed can be a traumatic experience. Anyway, so for what that's worth, I am going to say, please, for your own safety and future, reach out to those places. Now I'm going to click back to you, Diane. I'm going to click back to you. Please re-listen to those clearings. And please, sweet girl, please, 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 do not stop calling and do not stop reaching out to people today, because I feel like if you, I know it's going to be very difficult for you. I know you're going to be challenged in this next step because you're feeling very lost and you're feeling very afraid right now. And you're feeling very like, I don't know what to do. And when we're in that place, it's very difficult for us to make a move forward. So what I'm going to say to you is immediately, start making these phone calls. And the second thing I'm hearing is you need to, and I know one step at a time, but they want me to tell you this now. The second thing they really need you to do is to figure out what you can do so that you don't end up in this situation again. And whether that means having a good roommate or living in a place that's maybe like a one-room place, whatever it is, or being in a situation where only you control everything, just until you get in that place where you have stability and security, just keep working, 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 working. And that is what I am getting for you, sweetie.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. And our prayers will be with you. Our prayers will be with you that you find someplace and that everything works out. Okay, love?
Thank you, Toni. You have a very nice afternoon.
You too. Thank you.
You know, offering your message.
Oh my gosh, absolutely my pleasure. And I'm going to tell you something. The people who listen to my show, they are some of the most amazing people in the world. And I know that they will absolutely start praying for you and manifesting for you to have a place by the end of the week that you can go to and be in. And I know they will, because they're very caring and they're very loving, and they do want everybody to be in an amazing, beautiful place. Okay. And I'm so sorry for what you're going through. I'm going to go to 860-860. How are you today? What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Yeah. Hi, Toni. Thank you for taking my call. I'm calling from Connecticut. So I was just wondering the message for me at this time of my life? There are a lot of, a lot of stress and anxiety.
I can feel it. I can feel it. My heart is pounding. Okay. So you want a message from the other side about what you can do for the stress and anxiety. Am I getting that correctly, love?
Yeah, that. And what else do you see for me in the coming months and years?
Okay, so that's a private reading, love. If you want to look at coming months and years, I'm really, really super happy to help you with that. But that would be more of a private reading. I try to just answer one question or one connection on the show.
You know, I just don't want any detail. Like, I just want to, like, just like an umbrella.
Okay, let's go to 850. Hello, 850. How are you?
Fine. How are you?
Good. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Michelle, and I'm calling from Florida.
Hey, Michelle. How can I help you today?
Well, just any spiritual messages on our motor is broke and we can't move until our motor's fixed. So I'm kind of curious when you see the motor being fixed and when we'll be moving.
Okay, I hear instantly a month to a month and a half. And apparently, a month to a month and a half. And please be very vigilant about who or where you go. Now, I do feel like if you might need to work with someone you know is what I'm hearing to get this fixed. You might need to work with someone you know. And it's going to be a little bit chaotic to get... I'm hearing it's going to be a little chaotic to get the part, not to get it fixed, but to get the part that you need for this. And I do feel like it is going to come in a week to a week and a half, but you're getting this... these, whatever you need to fix your motor, I feel like I'm hearing you're getting it in like an unconventional way. However, now there is somebody on the other side who is very loving. And there's actually two people. There's a woman right next to me and a man. And I feel like if they're not parents, they're grandparents, and they are working with you, and they are laughing, and they're saying, what? I don't know that song. Be slower with it. They're like singing this song, this like, that's why I don't know the song. Okay, I hope this makes sense to you. It's the Gilligan's Island song, and I can't think of any of the words to it, but they're just saying Gilligan's Island. Just say Gilligan's Island. So whatever.
That is so wild that you said that, because I live on a boat, and we cannot move our boat. It's supposed to go at the end of the dock, and we do know the owners, just to clarification. So I think he's trying real hard to get us a motor or the outdrive fixed, and because it's an older engine, but we can't move to the end of the dock until we get the motor fixed. And that's what's funny, because you think Gilligan's Island, and here we live on our boat.
Okay.
And I want to go to the island, which is like Dog Island and Little St. George Island, and not very far. I don't care about going far out. I just want to enjoy the beach and the sun and take a little spin out to the little island, you know?
Me too. I'm going to be in Florida next month. So if we are in the same area, we will have to say hello, because it'll be nice to just, say hello. But that is exactly why I'm going to Florida, because I want some beach and some sun and some all the good stuff.
Where are you going?
I don't know yet. I have so many different friends in Florida. So I have Michelle and David, who are amazing. And I know I'm going to spend some time with them. And then I have a friend, Trista, in Fort Myers, and a friend, PJ, in Longboat. So there's all these different places that I could possibly, like, go to. But I know it sounds a little silly, but I really have this craving to go to Siesta Key also. So I might make it a little journey, but let's get back to you and this.
I hope you have fun.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, I think I will. I think it's going to be, I don't know. I know it's going to be quite the amazing trip. Anyway,
that's where my spiritual energy is.
Yeah. So what I'm getting is within a month to a month and a half, this should be fixed. It should be better. I do feel like I know you feel a little bit stressed about the situation right now. Just do the best you can to breathe through it. And I do feel like you are going to have to be patient about the part. Now, whether this is a part or the motor itself is the part, don't worry. It's all going to come together in the perfect timing. And I feel like by your motor, and they really want you to know this, and it's important to kind of look at it from this perspective. By your motor being broken and you being anchored, you are missing, like if you were out on the water, maybe something not so good would have, like there might have been something else that happened. So this is keeping you anchored actually to protect you. That's the way to say it. You're being anchored right now to protect you. So be patient through this process. Allow whatever is going on to go on and allow it to take the amount of time it needs. So whatever it was that you may had collided with, or however we're going to say it, whatever that was, that it will have time to pass. Okay. And this could be something maybe not on the water, but something like at your destination. So it's funny how it's amazing and miraculous how the universe works and brings you where you need to be, when you need to be at, and just to be patient for that. Okay, love.
Okay. That's awesome.
Excellent. Thank you.
And
so
I know what you mean by being protected, you know?
Absolutely, right? It's, yep, absolutely.
It really was. I was a truck driver and I pulled over at the rest area and I remember a camper trailer passing me, a fifth wheel. And when I got back on the road, they had flipped over not even a mile down the road. So the way I kind of look at it was a blessing that I had pulled off the road to go to the bathroom.
Oh my gosh.
So I think the intervention divine or God does everything for a reason.
Absolutely. Yes. And keep that in mind, as frustrated or as impatient as you may get to get where you're going. Keep that in mind because that is the exact same thing that's going on here. Okay, beautiful.
All right, honey. Thank you so much. And God bless.
God bless, love. Okay. We are at that point in the show where I have to say, if you are watching the 30-minute version of the show, please, you can go to YouTube and watch the rest of it, or any podcast and listen to the rest of it.